has your COPR expired or nearing expiring? Due to the pandemic, is it not possible for you to travel to Canada before your visa expires?
Keeping people like yourself in mind,
Canada has a process to apply for extension of your COPR. In this video, we are going to go through the eligibility for extension, the steps involved in applying for it, and our own experience in getting the extension.
So, if you are interested, stay tuned.
Hi, and welcome to Choose Canada. This is Roshan
and Lalita,
and we are here to help you immigrate and live in Canada.
We upload videos on immigrating to Canada and scoring high in IELTS almost every week. So, if you are new here and interested in our content, make sure you press that subscribe button and also the bell icon so that you stay up to date with our latest videos.
Due to the pandemic and the travel restrictions imposed in various countries to contain it, many people who have already got approved as permanent residents by Canada were unable to travel before their documents expired.
If you fulfill a certain criteria, you will be able to apply for an extension of your COPR. We ourselves were unable to travel within the validity of our COPR and went through the extension process to finally get approved.
This video will go through the eligibility that you need to meet for applying, what documents you need to prepare and submit, and also go over what to expect after you apply.
And make sure you watch till the very end of this video to learn our own experience with this extension process.
First, let's look at the eligibility that you need to meet before applying for this extension. IRCC, that is the wing responsible for immigration in Canada, has updated their website in a sort of detailed manner as to who is eligible to apply for this extension.
Canada has clearly mentioned that they do not want you to travel for the purpose of soft landing. Hence, if you are planning to visit Canada only for the purpose of fulfilling the PR requirements and then return back to your home country, then Canada recommends you not to apply for extension now, and they do not allow it currently.
For the other people who want to travel to Canada for the purpose of settling, they have classified the applicants into four different groups.
Group 1 includes people who are traveling from countries other than USA. If they have COPRs which were issued on or before 18th of March and their COPR is yet to expire, then they are exempt from travel restrictions and are welcome to travel to Canada.
Group 2 includes people traveling from the US. If they have valid COPRs that are yet to expire, they can travel to Canada regardless of the issue date.
Group 3 is where many people, including ourselves, fall into. These are people who are traveling from countries other than USA and have expired COPRs that were issued on or before 18th of March. These people are exempt from travel restrictions. However, they need to apply for extension in order to enter the country.
Group 4 includes people traveling from the US who have expired COPRs. These people are also exempt from travel restrictions and can apply for extension regardless of their COPR issue date.
So, before you apply for extension, make sure you fall into either Group 3 or Group 4. Now, let's move on to how you need to apply for extension. As we discussed earlier, you need to apply for extension only when you are ready to travel. Please do not apply for the extension if you are not ready to travel at short notice. You'll come to know why we insist on this by the end of this video.
Once you're ready to travel, you need to raise a web form stating the same and attach relevant documents with it.
Since there is a word limit in your web form, include only the most relevant details with the web form text. This includes your COPR issue date, COPR expiry date, the fact that you meet the travel restriction exemption, the reason you want to travel as soon as possible, and anything else you feel is most relevant.
In our case, since my company was ready to transfer me to Canada once we get the extension, we mentioned that as the reason for traveling to Canada. You can also mention your resignation, family reunification, or any other reason that you feel is applicable in this web form.
Then comes the documents you need to attach. IRCC wants you to attach your plans to follow the 14-day quarantine, settlement plan and travel itinerary. We recommend that you attach each of these as a separate Word document where you outline the plans with as much detail as possible.
The quarantine plan should include how you will arrange for accommodation, like using Airbnb or any hotel. You can even take a screenshot of the potential listing and attach it in the Word document like shown on the screen.
Apart from that, you also need to give your plans for arranging groceries and medicines. You can explain that you will use online apps to buy these products, or that you will have your friend or relative purchase and deliver it to you in the quarantine location.
With your quarantine plan, you also need to submit the proof of funds. Unlike the document you must have submitted for applying for PR, this can just be simple soft copies of bank balances, transactions or any other investments you have made. Attach these documents and give the list of documents you have attached with its values in a table within the Word file.
We personally have also mentioned how we will be using the quarantine period productively, like shortlisting rental properties we can move into, applying for jobs and giving e-interviews.
Then comes the settlement plan. Here, you need to mention what steps you are going to take to settle in Canada. You can explain what sites you will use to look for a rental property, or if applicable, even attach a rental agreement with the web form.
You can also mention how you are going to look for jobs, or if applicable, even attach a job offer letter that you got with the office address mentioned in the Word document.
Next comes the travel itinerary. Here you can mention the tentative date in which you are going to travel once you get the extension, and include screenshots of available flights on the date. IRCC recommends that you book flights with a maximum of one international layover, or preferably no international layover at all. So keep that in mind when you attach the screenshots.
In case you have already booked your air tickets to Canada, you can attach that to the web form as well. Having said that, do not book air tickets to Canada before getting the extension approved. It is very hard to get a refund from Airways nowadays.
Apart from these documents, you can also attach your COPR documents with the web form to show that you meet the travel exemptions. Once you have attached your documents, you can submit the web form and wait for further communication from IRCC.
There is one more thing you need to do, that is to hit the like button so that this video reaches more people who are in position similar to you. Hope you have hit the like button. Now let's look at what to expect after you have submitted your web forms.
After raising the web form, you will be getting an acknowledgement from IRCC stating that your application has been forwarded to the responsible office. You will be getting this acknowledgement via email within 10 days of raising the web form.
After this comes the long wait. Canada has not given any timeline for processing extension requests as of today when this video is being prepared. From what we saw, they seem to pick files in a random manner.
We have seen applicants who applied for extension before us and still waiting for the approval. On the other hand, we have also seen applicants who applied after us and got processed within a week. Hence, there seems to be no pattern in which the files are being picked.
Once Canada does approve your extension, you can expect one out of two things to happen. One is receiving an authorization letter in your email. The other is getting a passport request or PPR mail. This will depend largely on whether the visa application centers or VAC in your country has opened or not.
In case your country has opened their VAC, you will most likely get a PPR mail. In that case, you need to submit your passport to the VFS office and get a new visa stamped in your passport. The validity of the visa in this case would be at least 4 months or even more than that.
In case the VACs in your country are closed, you will most likely get an authorization letter or AL. In case you get an AL, you do not need any visa stamping in your passport. All you need to do is take a printout of the AL that is attached in the email and show it to the airlines when you are boarding the plane.
The validity of the AL being issued can be anywhere between 3 weeks to 2 months. There were even people who got a validity of just 8 days. In any case, the maximum validity you can expect is 2 months and not more than that.
Before getting the AL, some applicants have got an email from IRCC asking if they are ready to travel within the next 60 days. This is called the four-pointer email, as it has 4 questions that needs to be answered. Applicants having their primary visa office in New Delhi generally gets this email. You can find your primary VO by looking at your PPR email.
Other applicants have got a message in their GC account asking if they can travel before so and so date. And if they cannot, they need to apply for the medical exams again. People are expected to reply to this message by raising a web form. If they intimate that they can travel before the specified date, they generally get the AL within 1 week of time or even sooner.
IRCC may also ask for new medicals or police clearance certificate if they deem that your documents have expired. How this expiry is calculated is still unclear as of preparing this video. Another important point to check once you get your AL is whether a new counterfoil has been updated in your GC account or not. Log in to your GC account and check if the document status has been updated with new counterfoils.
Do not plan your travel until the new counterfoil is updated in your GC account, as there is a good chance that you might get denied from boarding your flight at the time of travel. In case it's not updated, call and follow up with IRCC until it is updated in your GC account.
These are the types of cases that we saw for COPR extension as of the day when this video is being prepared. That being said, in the future, things might get smoother for the applicants.
Coming to our own experience with the COPR extension process, our COPRs expired on 12th of August and we raised our first web form to IRCC on 28th of August after I got the confirmation from my organization that they need me to travel to Canada for project support.
We raised a detailed web form following the steps that we gave in the earlier part of this video, with a tentative travel date by the end of September. We did not get any response till the end of September. Hence, we raised another web form on 29th September stating that we can travel by mid-October, furnishing the same documents we gave in the first web form.
Since we did not get any update till mid-October as well, we raised another web form on 14th of October intimating that we can travel by early November. Now, we finally got the authorization letter close to the midnight of 19th of October, which is valid till 19th of December. We also got a new counterfoils updated in our GC account on the same day.
Apart from this, we also sent mails to the email IDs that are shown on the screen. This includes New Delhi VO email since our home country is India, Ottawa VO since that is our primary VO, and other 2 email IDs related to travel exemptions and rapid response team.
We were insanely lucky that we got our extensions within 2 months of raising the first web form and that it has a validity of 2 whole months. We have left links to the documents we used in the description box below so that you can edit and use as per your requirement for raising the web form.
We honestly feel you'll get progress with your extensions too, and we'll be booking your flights to Canada sooner than you expect. So don't lose hope and all the best on your journey to Canada.
Thank you for watching this video. We hope you found it helpful and informative.
If you have any doubts or need any clarifications, make sure you comment below. We'll be reading all your comments and we'll try to respond to any of your questions.
Meanwhile, if you found this video helpful, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more content.
We'll meet you on our next video. Till then, have a great day and all the best on your journey to Canada.